Hello, this is Bob from Project Sentry Gun. Today we're going to do a quick demo on the Sentry Controller Standalone version 7. This has just been released. The latest batch is completely backordered as of right now, and I have more backorders waiting after those backorders. So it's very popular, but I'm just going to highlight some of the main features for those of you who have it or are waiting to get one, so you can understand how to hook it up in your project. First couple improvements over the last version, we have a mini USB, mini B jack instead of the full-size jack we had before. This one's more popular, more widely available, easier to get cables for it, and takes up less board space as well, and space in your project. Secondly, the AT Mega is now full surface mount, TQFP version instead of the P-Dip large through-hole version we had before. That makes board much smaller, as you can see, almost half the size of version 5. And the power jack is now surface mount, as you can see, doesn't go through, as well as one of the capacitors, the 10 microfarad capacitor that used to be on here is now surface mount. And the button's smaller, some things are moved around over here. Generally, it's just a smaller version of the old one. New functionality, we have two extra analog pins down here that can also be used as digital I.O. pins. Those are for your own expansions, whatever you guys want to do with them. So those aren't too bad of an addition. Let's see. I think that's about it for new features. A couple small technical things, but you guys probably don't care much about those. Anyways, how to hook it up. These three over here are your servo connections for trigger, pan, and tilt. They have next to them little minus signs on these sides. That's for the black wire to your servo. Don't hook them up the wrong way, it won't work. Shouldn't fry your servos, but it's just bad to do. So make sure you get the black wire to the minus. This is the servo power jack. Plug in, it's 5.5mm barrel jack. I think 2.1 or 2.5 on the inside. And that's center positive. So when you're hooking up your servo power source, keep that in mind. This servo power switch just turns the power on and off to your servos. On is this position, off is that position. On, off, like that. Next to that, there's two bypass points if you want to solder in your own switch. This is also recommended for high current servos. The traces on the board can handle up to an estimated 7 amps-ish, 5 or 7 amps, but this switch is not rated that high, so if you want to use those heavy-duty servos, put in your own switch right there. Other bypass, this one right here, is servo power bypass if you don't want to use a jack and want to solder directly to the board. These two are labeled nicely, servo power and bypass, generally for the servo power, for the switch, right on the bottom of the board for that. There is a ISP header right here. If you know what that is, you may be pleased by that. If you don't know what it is, you don't need to worry about it. It's just for programming the board. And see, all these expansions over here, digital I.O., analog I.O., pin numbers are labeled on the bottom of the board. When you want to hook up your USB, obviously just plug it in. It should install its own drivers, say yes to anything it wants, it'll install its own drivers. And lastly, down here at the bottom, we have a range of connectors. If we flip over to the bottom, we can see what those are. It is labeled, first these two down here, DP is for disable plate, and RL is for reload. If you want to hook up a reload switch, just attach it to these two, and a disable plate switch to those two. The disable plate is a button that goes on the back of a plate that when shot will disable a sentry for a period that you can define in the code. Reload switch similarly disables it whenever that switch is held down. Up here at the top, there is GB and GM, with minus signs here and plus signs here. GB stands for gun battery and GM for gun motor. This is if you want to use the electric trigger functionality. This is usually for electric airsoft guns, though some people have used it for electric paintball guns as well. In which case, for the airsoft guns, hook up the motor, electric motor of the airsoft gun to these two, make sure it's a DC motor, and the proper battery to GB these two. And I believe these are also high current rated up to 5 or 7 amps. Which should be okay for most guns, especially for short periods of time, though may heat up if you have a higher amperage in that. That just connects the motor and runs the motor when the sentry is firing. I think that's all of the functionality things we have for you. Oh, LEDs. There's a mode LED up here. Down here, in order from bottom to top, we have power, RX, and TX. Those will tell you the serial status, and this lights up green when the board is receiving power. And up here we have a red LED that just indicates when the sentry's trying to fire. Alright, now I'm just going to quickly hook this up with a servo and a battery pack, just to give you an idea of how it works. Here's our battery pack. It's just got, inside, 4 AA batteries that get 6 volts for my servos. These don't last very long, but they're rechargeable, so it's not a big deal. I'd say you could probably get about 8 hours straight on AA's, at least with the servos that I'm using. So here's the servo, but first, we just plug this battery pack right into the servo power jack right there. Looks nicely. If you have a switch on your battery pack like I do, just make sure it's in the on position. Now the servos, this is just a standard servo. So we have yellow, red, and black. They're kind of painted, but you can get an idea of which is which. Remember, we want the black to the minus one, so I'm gonna hook this up to pan. And finally, USB connection. Just plug that in right up there. You see the status lights immediately come on. I get some blinking action. When you do this, it should install some drivers of its own on your computer. Click allow to that stuff. And then we're just going to run the processing code. Now you see over here, the RX LED is pulsing, indicating we have a connection with the computer. When I fire over here on the screen, the fire LED is going to light up. And when I turn the servo power on, I'm going to check out the servo, and then I move on the processing screen, the servo moves accordingly. If we put this in the trigger output, we're just going to get, when we fire, servo's going to move position to squeeze the trigger if you have it hooked up like that. And panning should be similar to tilt, except on the opposite axis. Over to the processing screen for a minute. Ooh, there we are. This is just the usual code running. If you want to or need to update the code, sorry if this is a little fuzzy, it's going to go to Arduino, to Tools, Board, and let me see if I can get this for you. We just want Arduino Duo Melanove with ATmega 328, like that. Hit Upload, and it's compiling. Let's look at the board. See the lights pulsing, indicating that's uploading to the board. And then, done, it flashes the mode LED, and it's ready to go again. So we need to update code, that's all you need to do. None of the fancy hardware stuff that we had to do for the last version. So that's it. Thanks for watching.